Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of Autocar India's Quick News, your weekly updates on all the launches, the big scoops and the hot news from the world of automobiles. But before we begin, do remember to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest videos. Let's start off with the launches this week, and as the deadline for BS6 looms in closer and closer, the number of BS6 cars launched every week is just going to increase. This week, Maruti Suzuki launched the BS6 version of the popular Wagon R. The new BS6 Wagon R will get no change in power from the BS4 models and will continue to get a 5-speed manual or AMT gearbox. The upgrade to BS6 on the 1-litre engine has seen the ARAI rated fuel efficiency drop by 0.71 km per litre from 22.5 to 21.79 km per litre. Prices for the new BS6 Wagon R 1-litre have gone up by 8,000 rupees on every model, with the range now starting at 4.42 lakh. While the hike for petrol BS6 cars won't be substantial, diesel BS6 car prices are set to go up by a much bigger margin. Isuzu, that has purely a diesel portfolio, is set to increase prices of its D-Max, V-Cross pickup truck and MU-X SUV by up to 3 to 4 lakh rupees, while commercial models like the D-Max regular cab and the D-Max S cab are set to rise by 1 to 1.5 lakh rupees. And in line with the BS6 theme, here is an Autocar India exclusive. We have the scoop on how the new BS6 version of the Honda City will be priced. The BS6 Honda City Petrol will be launched in India soon and will continue to get the same 1.5-litre 119 horsepower engine mated to a manual or a CVT gearbox. The car will be available in a total of 7 variants. Prices for the new Honda City BS6 are expected to go up by between 10,000 and 16,000 rupees depending on the variant. Hyundai will soon launch its sub 4-meter compact sedan, the Aura, and that will replace the Accent, of course. And now we have information on what engines and gearboxes the Aura will have. Let's have a quick look. The Hyundai Aura will come with three engine options. First up, the 1.2-litre naturally aspirated 4-cylinder petrol engine that will make 83 horsepower and 114 Nm of torque. A 1.2-litre 3-cylinder turbo diesel engine will make 75 horsepower and 190 Nm of torque. The Aura will also have a 1-litre turbo engine from the Venue, although in a lower state of tune, making about 100 horsepower. Gearbox options will include a 5-speed manual or AMT on both the 1.2-litre engines, while the 1-litre turbo motor will get only a manual gearbox. Let's move on to what seems to be everybody's favourite body style, the SUV. And this week in the news, we have a literal ton of SUVs, starting off with the very sleek and very sexy Aston Martin DBX. The new Aston Martin DBX is the first ever SUV from the sport car maker and slots in between the Porsche Cayenne and the Bentley Bentayga in terms of overall length. While Aston's typically pretty styling include the Vantage-like rear end, the DBX is made from bonded aluminium panels. Under the bonnet, the DBX is powered by a 4-litre AMG-sourced V8 that makes 550 horsepower and 700 Nm of torque with a top speed of about 290 km per hour. For more on the DBX, visit our website autocarindia.com. Sticking to the theme of super SUVs, here is Audi's new flagship and the current Nürburgring lap record holder for SUVs, the brand new Audi RS Q8. The new Audi RS Q8 features sportier styling as compared to the regular Q8 and gets a 4-litre V8 making 600 horsepower. 0 to 100 is taken care of in just 3.8 seconds onto a top speed of 250 km per hour or 304 km per hour with the optional dynamic package. The engine is also boosted by a 48-volt mild hybrid starter generator. Of course, the RS Q8 gets quattro all-wheel drive and an 8-speed automatic. Check out our detailed first look video of the RS Q8 on the Autocar India YouTube channel. Ford has finally taken the wraps off its first ever electric SUV. It's called the Mustang Mach-E. And that's a name that's inspired, of course, from the late 60s Mustangs called the Mach 1. Now, if you're wondering why the Mustang tag exists, that's because Ford will soon use the Mustang tag in its lineup of electric vehicles. Built to take on the upcoming Tesla Model Y, the Mustang Mach-E is the brainchild of Team Edison, a special 70-person team inside Ford tasked with designing EVs. The Mustang badge, as we mentioned earlier, has of course inspired several design features on the SUV, including the front grille,
the headlamps, and the iconic tail lamps. On the inside, the Mach-E gets a vertically mounted 15.5-inch touchscreen infotainment system, as seems to be the norm with most new cars recently, and a 10.2-inch instrument cluster. The car sits on a new platform christened the GE2 or Global Electrified 2 and gets a 75 kWh battery and 258 hp motor, or a 99 kWh battery and a 289 hp motor, both of which produce 460 Nm of torque. The Mach-E gets from 0 to 100 in just 8 seconds and has a range of either 450 or 595 kilometers. From sporty SUVs to an uber-luxurious one, here is the all-new Mercedes-Maybach GLS600. Available in either a 4-seat or 5-seat configuration, the new GLS Maybach differentiates itself from the regular GLS with a new vertical slat chrome grille, similar to what you get on the likes of a Maybach Spec S-Class. The GLS Maybach also gets a lot more chrome up front, including a lower mesh grille and skid plates, both finished in high-gloss chrome. The car also features 22-inch or optional 23-inch wheels, along with an optional two-tone paint job. Under the bonnet is a 4-litre V8 with an EQ Boost mild hybrid setup. Power is rated at 558 hp, with a top speed of 209 km/h on the American version and 250 km/h on the European version.
The Mahindra Rockshore is an off-roader that Mahindra makes and sells exclusively in the North American market, and it's soon getting a bit of an update. Let's take a look at what it will look like.
As part of its 2020 update, the Mahindra Rockshore, which has managed to gather quite the fan following since its launch, will now get an all-new front-end styling with a new honeycomb grille. It also gets a plastic border around the headlamps. While the engine will remain the same, a 2.5-litre diesel mated to a 5-speed manual or a 6-speed auto, the Rockshore will now get an updated 5.38 axle ratio, which will help with its off-road ability.
And finally, rounding up that SUV theme, India has a new SUV bestseller. Now that crown, of course, was held by the Mahindra Bolero for years on end, and then of course by the Maruti Suzuki Vitara Brezza, and now the crown has been passed on to the Kia Seltos.
The Kia Seltos, in just its third month since launch, is now the highest selling SUV in India. With 12,786 units sold in October 2019, the Seltos beat the Brezza's sales for October by a whopping 2,559 units. While the Kia Seltos is doing exceedingly well in India, Kia also showcased the Seltos for the first time in the United States at the LA Auto Show. Apart from the regular version, Kia also showcased these rather cool concept cars called the X-Line Trail Attack and the X-Line Urban, based on the all-wheel drive Seltos. Both cars feature a 2-inch lift along with added driving lights and custom paint jobs.
Now we've had a bunch of very cool cars unveiled this week. The Aston Martin DBX, the Mustang Mach-E, the Mercedes Maybach GLS, but nothing is as crazy as what you're about to see. This is the Tesla Cybertruck, Tesla's first all-electric pickup truck, and yes, it does look like a sci-fi fiction dream from the 1980s of what 2020 would look like, and it's very much here to stay. Have a look at this.
What is possibly the most polarizing vehicle launched in recent times in terms of design, the brand new Tesla Cybertruck was showcased to the world by Elon Musk earlier this week. The futuristic design that almost looks like something a sci-fi movie from the 70s or 80s depicting the 2000s would have, features a wedge-shaped design that is made entirely out of what Tesla calls 30X cold roll stainless steel. Tesla claims that it is dent-resistive, and as an add-on bonus, it has semi-bulletproof capabilities too. Under the skin, the Cybertruck gets adaptive suspension and 8 inches of total travel. The pickup also gets 3 motor setups, a single, a dual, or a tri, with a range of 400, 480, and a whopping 800 km respectively. And as with all Teslas, the figures are outstanding. The Cybertruck can get from 0 to 100 in less than 2.9 seconds, and Tesla claims that the pickup can carry up to 1.5 tons in its load bed and tow up to 6.4 tons. Truly staggering figures.
And that's all we have time for this week on the news. Do let us know what you think of that absolutely outlandish Tesla and all the other SUVs we've showcased this week. As always, do leave your opinions in the comments section below. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next week.